Hi, I'm Maura Hardy, Assistant Secretary of State for Consular Affairs, and I want to tell you about an important adjustment we are announcing today concerning travel by American citizens to Canada, Mexico, the Caribbean, and Bermuda. As you may know, the Western Hemisphere Travel Initiative was mandated by Congress to strengthen border security and facilitate entry into the United States by citizens and legitimate travel of international visitors. In part, the law required American citizens to have passports coming back into the United States from Canada, Mexico, the Caribbean, and Bermuda. This law and its requirements took effect on January 23rd of 2007 for people who were traveling by air. In the last few months, we faced a record-breaking demand for passports as a result of American citizens trying to comply with that law. This increase in requests, over and above even the enormous demand we anticipated, has resulted in a longer-than-expected processing time for passport applications, and we recognize regrettably that this has caused a hardship for some Americans. In light of the current situation, we announced today that from now through September 30th of this year, U.S. citizens traveling to Canada, Mexico, the Caribbean, and Bermuda, who have applied for but not yet received passports, can temporarily enter and depart the United States by air without a passport. To do so, U.S. citizens must have a government-issued photo identification and Department of State official proof of application for a passport. Adults who have applied for but not yet received a passport should present government-issued photo identification and an official proof of application from the U.S. Department of State. Children under the age of 16 traveling with their parents or legal guardian will be permitted to travel with the child's proof of application. Travelers who have not applied for a passport should not expect to be accommodated. U.S. citizens with pending passport applications can obtain proof of their application at www.travel.state.gov. A list of frequently asked questions and their answers is available at that same internet site. This accommodation does not affect entry requirements to other countries, including Europe, Asia, Africa, and South America. Americans traveling to a country that requires passports must still present those documents. We're committed to providing high-quality service to American citizens. As U.S. consular officers, we have been doing this kind of work since 1780. We hope that this flexibility will accommodate American citizens' travel needs, even as we continue every day to improve the security of our travel documents. Thanks very much.